The glorpening begins. Who is the orange one? You don't like my drawing? Olorp. Here he is. What is it? What do you mean? Hey, thank you for the sub. Sabotaged, thank you for the sub. Goodbye, Olorp. Show hand, hand check. Shrez! Hand check. The body is an amazing thing. I am healed. Guys, it's so not broken, it's actually crazy. Look at this. How's the prop tree look now that's dry? Like, poopy. Like, poopy! I need to go in with, like, acrylic paints and, like, my actual paintbrushes and paint it. But I give up. I gave up. Zephyr! Thank you for the three. Thank you for the tier three. Thank you. Thank you, Zephyr. Hearts Barts. Thank you. Thank you, it's a Lego. Hearts Balts. Guys, you know what tomorrow is? We don't hear alerts. What? Stand by. That's super awkward because I was just waiting for that tier three alert. Sorry, no, you didn't hear it. You know what tomorrow is? What's tomorrow? The rock party. The rock party tomorrow, which means it's really, I really shouldn't be doing this today because we have to go set up for the rock party. We had alerts made literally overnight. Shout out Dion and 96, wahoo. And we are working on, we have to transport the rocks to Nick's, and we have to bring the three big rocks. I told y'all the top three donators get like boulders. Did you know that? The top three donators are getting like big rock with like their username on it. So we have to source big rocks and then take them to Nick's and then have them on display. Top three places. And then we'll write your name really big, a big rock. Yeah, it'll be cool. It'll be cool. Can we gift rocks? No. Sorry. I don't know how to do that. Are you bringing a forklift? No, but we are bringing Nick. Are you dating Tarek? What? Nobody has ever asked me that before. That is so random. That is so funny. I don't even know where he lives. I don't even know what he does. Does he play Valorant? Avoiding the question? No, I'm not dating Tarek. I don't even know if it's Tarek or Tarek. I think it's Tarek. But no, I'm not dating Tarek. Guys, Connor's back. Hooray! Yay! Rock party tomorrow. You know, every time I say Connor now, they type in caps custard.
I hate that.
You did that to yourself.
You
did the custard bit. I did not do that. And also, you came up with the name custard, so do not come at me. Okay. All right. Guys, today is Thursday. Today is Wednesday. Today is Wednesday. Yes. Today is Wednesday. Tomorrow is Thursday, which is the rock party. And then Friday is my kickflip stream. How long between tweets do you think I should wait? If I tweeted this morning, is it fine if I tweet now? How long ago was my tweet this morning? Like 2 hours? So you think it's fine if I tweet right now? Oh, yeah, I am. I should wait because I have to do another tweet in an hour. Damn, I'm going to tweet 3 times today. There's a trailer for the kickflip video. It's so good. It's so good. I'm excited for you guys to see it. Yeah, the kickflip stream is now on Friday at 11 a.m. CT. Because I won't be here Saturday anymore. I'm not streaming Saturday. Is someone coming to help? Yeah, Ricky Glasser. The professional skateboarder that has the world record for most kickflips in a minute. He's going to teach me. He's coming to Texas. I'm not flying him out for it. He was already going to be in Texas. I'm not that crazy. But yeah, he's going to be in Texas. I'm excited. It'll be good. It'll be good. All right. Someone asked when the first collab in April is. It's April 9th. With Eret and Chris. Okay. Are you doing anything for the eclipse on Monday? Yeah, I'm playing football.
What?
I'm doing a football stream. I think I'll be good by then. I think I'll be fine by then. I'm doing a football stream with S-Fan and E-Rob and Peach Jars. Unless it rains. If it rains, it'd be really sad. Yeah, it'd be really sad. We'll see. Okay, are you guys ready? Do you have any other questions, comments, concerns before I continue? Haunted Pause, thank you for the 8 months. Did you guys know it's April of 2024? Do you know what that means? I've been streaming for 5 years. Space, do you know that? I started streaming in April of 2019. I've been streaming 5 years.
Meeple Pug, wow.
Gall! Dude! I was gonna say that has to be, that's a great sub for this moment. Gall has been subbed for 57 months. Gall, thank you. Insane. Insane. 2019 was only 2.5 years ago. Actually, it was 5 years ago. Okay, do you guys have any other questions, comments, concerns before I continue on with the stream? Or are we ready to rumble? Ready. Chat! Welcome to the first ever, not annual, because I'm not doing it again, chat Olympics. I'm glad you're here, because if you're here on time, it means that you have the most chance to get points. Everybody that shows up late to the stream is at a severe disadvantage, because they're going to miss some of the Olympic Games, and they're not going to have a chance to win points. But you are all here. So you're ready to go. Here's how this works today. Somebody said, what do I win?
Wow.
First place. Noah, thank you for the 14 months. If you win, you win. Compete to win. Welcome to the Chat Olympics. Okay, how does this work, you may ask? You will have to be participating, okay? This is no second monitor stream. All right? I know I usually am, but not today. You need to focus up, okay? You need to eat a big athletic breakfast with a lot of carbs. You need to drink an energy drink. You need to drink your pre-workout. All right? You need to get ready to go. Because you will be participating in the chat Olympics today. I'm in bed. Lock in, brother. You better lock it in. Are you already tired? Does it sound like I'm tired? I'm the host of the Olympics. No, I'm not tired. We have bits.
Got my meth, I'm ready.
Ah! I never said you needed that. You don't need that. Okay. Chat, there are four. There are four games. There are four Olympic games that you will be competing in today. Each game is an opportunity for points, okay? The four games are, number one, Type Racer. How good are you at Type Racer, chat? How fast can you type words per minute? Tell me right now. Tell me right now. 90, 130, 69, 5, 80. Zorath, thank you for the tier 3. 85, 34, 100, 100, 120. Like 120. Okay. Zorath, thank you for the tier 3.
Handicap bonus.
Tier 3 unfortunately does not get a handicap bonus. I'm very sorry. That guy that types 120 words per minute, you guys gotta watch out for that guy, okay? This is like Fall Guys. You gotta grab him, you gotta throw him off the edge because he's going to win the points. Top 10 fastest, most accurate typers get 10 points. All of these games are worth 10 points, okay? You will see a sentence on screen. You will type the sentence in chat correctly, with capitals, with punctuation. You will type it with correct spelling. And if you match up the sentence exactly, and you're in the top 10 people to type that fast, then you get 10 points. If you want to keep track of your points, there will be a leaderboard on screen, but you can also do command points if you want to see the leaderboard. If you're on mobile, rest in peace. That is game number one. Game number two. By the way, the chat Olympics is Alveus themed. If you're a true fan and you're an Alveus viewer, congratulations, you're at an advantage. This is all Alveus themed because it's more fun that way. Type Racer, you don't actually have to know anything because you're just typing a sentence. But the next Olympic game will be an Alveus lore quiz. It will be multiple choice. I will ask you questions, and you will be able to type what you think the answer to those questions are, okay? If you get the question correct, you get 10 points. Understood? Olympic game number three. Pictionary. As you could see, I very accurately drew Olorp this morning, and I will continue drawing for you guys today. I will be drawing ambassadors, and you will need to guess who they are. The first 10 people to guess that ambassador, is that accurate?
First 10
people to guess the ambassador that I'm drawing correctly get 10 points. Then we check the leaderboard. We see who's in the lead, okay? And then the very last Olympic game, the make or break, if you will, for these chatters, is going to be two truths and a lie about the ambassador. And you will have to guess in a poll system, one, two, or three, which is the lie. And if you get it correct, then you win points. Does everybody understand what we're doing today? Can I be on a team with Curdy? No, these are individual sports. If you'd like to pick teams, you're more than welcome to, but it doesn't make any sense because you won't be working together. But if you want to do it for morale, go ahead. Pick your teams. at your team members. Please. Nicknames are not allowed. You have to type the actual name. Okay, they're making teams out of glorps. Don't, Max, don't say red gang. Don't, I said to at your, I said at other chatters, not pick a color. I don't like that you're making colored gangs. Don't. Chat, okay. Everybody. I think I've started a revolution. Okay. Does everybody understand how the Olympics work? Should we wait for anybody else to filter in? Or you think it's been long enough and you think they're too fake to have a shot at the first game? Fake. Fake. All right, let's go over the rules one more time. We got four games. We have Type Racer. We have Alveus Lore Quiz. We have Pictionary. And then we have Two Truths and a Lie. Understand? What do you get if you win? Chat? A win. That's exactly right. Thank you for participating. All right, let's get Type Racer ready. Chat, Type Racer is first. I will remind you, even though I've already told you. What the heck was that?
Less than three.
Oh, you bought merch. Yay, Winnie hoodie. I will remind you one more time. Here's how this is going to work. There's a sentence that will pop up on screen here. You have to type the sentence as fast as you can. Okay? And it has to be accurate, with capitals, with punctuation. The first 10 people to type the sentence correctly get 10 points. And that is the start of our leaderboard. If you're on mobile, you better type fast. Really fast. Okay, are you guys ready? Is everybody ready? I need a yes. The first question is simple. They said aye. Okay. All right. In 3, 2, 1. Stompy is wicked, crazy, super fast. Who's typing? Who's typing? Who's typing? Who's typing? Who's typing? Oh! Oh my god. Hansel! In first place. You guys can give up. You're too slow. You're too slow. Abruxius, Spaghetti, Spicy, Boogie, Wonka, MXida, Dog, Crispy Minutes, and Nimble Toe. In top 10, these are the only people with points. You can call this a warm-up if you want, but these are real points. So the person in first place right now is Hansel. Guys, if you're still typing it, you are either on mobile or you're copy-pasting someone else's chat, which is obviously not going to work. So give up. All right, yes, the period counted. I made that so clear. Don't come at me. I said punctuation and capitals and spelling matter. You have to be exactly accurate. All right, we have a second question. Are you ready? Or a second sentence. In 3, 2, 1, go. Madagascar hissing cockroaches are ovoviviparous. Spelling counts. That was actually crazy fast. Connor's trying to cheat and he can't get it. Resolution singular, NMPLOL, Saucy McBossy, Low Road, Boogie, Jankowski, Faith of Dev, Momo, Flair, and XY Sint. Dude, Boogie is now got to be in first place. Yes, dude, Boogie is top 10. First two sentences. That was so hard. What the heck? Skill issue. Skill issue. You guys have three more sentences to redeem yourself, but Boogie is super in the win right now. He's the fastest chatter in the West. screw you guys, I'm taking my ball and I'm going home. We're not even all the way through the first Olympic game. Question number three. Do you guys need a second? Or are you ready? They're ready. Sentence number three. 3, 2, 1, go. Every time someone calls Barbara ugly, her feelings get hurt. Capitals matter. Punctuation matters. Spelling matters. Okay, this is big. Top 10 are locked in. Resolution, singular, strange, cyan, low road, sim racing, daunting, encephalon, Buell Truman, photon, NMP, LOL. That's their second. Oh, resolution, singular, too. And low road. Hello? Dude. Chat, your competition just increased. Tenfold. Nick, thank you for the raid. Chat, new chatters, hello, welcome to my stream. It's been a minute. I'm excited to see you tomorrow. Guys, you came in just in time. You actually have a chance here. Welcome to the chat Olympics. Don't say no explaining. I am going to explain it. Guys, raiders, welcome to the chat Olympics, where you can compete to win. What do you get if you win? First place. There are four Olympic Games. The first Olympic game that we're working on right now is Type Racer. We are giving you sentences and you are typing them in chat. Spelling matters. That is not good for NMPLOL viewers. Punctuation matters. That is not good for NMPLOL viewers. And being fast matters. Also not good for NMPLOL viewers. First 10 people to type the sentence correctly get 10 points. We have a leaderboard. Some people are already in the lead and have been in the top 10 twice. If you're on mobile, get fricked.
Wow.
Olympic game number two, Alvaeus lore quiz. A lot of you are fake and not Alvaeus fans, and you're probably not going to know any of the answers. If you followed Alvaeus Sanctuary, maybe you would know. Olympic games number three, Pictionary. I will be drawing animals and you will be guessing what they are. First 10 people to guess what the animal is wins points. Olympic Games number four, Two Truths and a Lie Ambassador Edition. I will tell you two truths and one lie about the animals at Alvaeus, and you have to guess what they are. Understood? Right now we're on Type Racer. Are you guys ready to lock in? Yes or no? Chat, are you ready to lock in? We already have done three. You only have two more Type Racers to go. They're ready.
Wow.
Happy 1 year, Mayo.
Thank you for the year. All right. Sentence number four. 3, 2, 1, go. When Toaster Strudel sheds his skin, his little mittens keep their shape. Punctuation matters. Spelling matter. How is that possible? Dude, this guy's insane. Resolution singular has now gotten top 10 three times. Daunting Daryl got another one as well. NMP LOL is now on their third top 10 as well. That's actually crazy. Let's see the leaderboard. Resolution Singular is up here with 30 points, and so is NMP LOL. Boogie Woogie at 20 points. Low Road with 20 points. Daunting with 20 points. And Simon. Truman and Lucky. Hansel and Abruxius. All right. Maya, this is a terrible idea, by the way. Is it because you're not on the leaderboard, Zano? Or is there another reason that you think that?
The typing is coming from inside the room.
Yeah, you're right. All right. We have one more sentence in our Type Racer Olympic Games chat. Get your fingers ready. Take your pre-workout. Drink your energy drink. Do whatever you have to do. Type Racer. Last sentence. 3, 2, 1, go. Winnie the Moo is a 2-year-old baby cow and only eats grain out of her favorite blue bucket. Capitals matter. No, some of them missed it. Loopy Loot! Loopy Loot, Strange Cyan, M. Simon, Elron, Scrotus, Rick Cyan, Photon, Boogie Woogie again, Eretzi, and Shut Up Leonard, top 10. Guys, if you're still typing, it's time to give up. If you want to copy and paste another chatter's message so you feel like you did it, that's fine, but you won't get any points, but you're welcome to. Boogie Woogie is still in first. Well, actually, they're all tied for first place. Boogie Woogie, Resolution, Singular, NMPLOL, and Enf Simon are all in first place. What do you guys think? Are you stressed? Type Racer really stresses me out. I would be really stressed if I was you right now. What are we doing? Chat Olympics. I'm stressed. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. We're going to go to the next game, though, okay? We have a quiz. This is for points, too, all right? We're doing a bit of a lore quiz. Some of the questions are easier. Some of the questions are harder. There's a couple questions that are so hard, I think it's going to set a lot of you apart from the others. All right? Type Racer's over. It's time for the comeback. Are you ready? Moving on into our second Olympic game. We have Alveus lore questions. This is multiple choice. I will ask you a question, and then you will type what you think the answer is, A, B, C, or D, except for the last question. There's a lot more options than that. Okay, don't guess. I haven't said the question yet. Don't try to cheat right now. Ban the cheaters. They're cheating. I'm going to ask you the question, and you're going to guess which one you think is right, okay? Capitalization doesn't matter. It's multiple choice. You just have to type A, B, C, or D. Are you ready for question number one? Slow mode? No! This is not a day for slow mode. This is the chat frickin' Olympics, dude. Yeah, you can Google, but you're gonna frickin' know. You're gonna Google, but you're gonna lose. Question number one. Alveus lore quiz, Olympic Games number two. What enclosure was the first to go up at Alveus? Was it the crow enclosure, the chicken coop, the training yard, or the parrot aviary? Think back to 2021, people. It's now 2024. What was the first enclosure to go up at Alveus? What do you think? Cubs, thank you for resubbing. You cannot guess in your sub message. You have to type it in chat, but thank you so much. You cannot pay to win. All right, their guesses are in. I'll give you guys a few more minutes to get. Okay, I'll give you guys, not a few more minutes, I'm sorry. I'll give you guys like 30 more seconds or something to guess what you think it is. You can copy other chatters' answers, but they are all over the place. Like all over the place. The answer is not the wolf enclosure. That is incorrect. I need 2 more hours. No. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The correct answer is the parrot aviary. I did see a lot of people typing D. Congratulations. 47% of you are correct. 47%. That's pretty good. Let's look at the leaderboard. Everybody's in the same place. Wait, no! Photon and Shut Up Leonard! They got those, so they're climbing, dude. That's crazy. They're all tied for first. Wait, Boogie got that too. So Boogie's actually in first. They're not tied for first. Boogie's in first place. Dude. Okay. All right. Boogie, you're crazy. You're crazy. All right. Question number two. Are you ready? Speed does not matter here. Speed does not matter. It's 10 points if you get it correct. Time does not matter. All right. Question number two. What month did Alveus start streaming live cams on Twitch 24/7? Some NMP chatters in here like, they do what? Confirm for $5. They're like, you guys have live cams? The right answer, smile. No. You cannot pay to win. Was it September, November, January, or March? What do you think? Do you remember? I didn't yesterday. I had to look it up. All right. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The correct answer is November. 65% of you got that right. That's actually kind of crazy. I'm very surprised that you guys knew that. Is it because you were copying other chatters? How many of you just copied what other chatters were saying? Be honest. I copied. Me smile.
Yeah, I'm a simp for Maya. What can I say?
PewDiePie? Hunter, thank you for the tier 2. You get extra points. I'm kidding. All right, leaderboard. Boogie is now tied with Enf Simon and Shut Up Leonard for first place. Dude, Leonard, you're going crazy. Okay. Are you guys ready for the next question? Ruko, thank you for the sub. Wild said Boogie is my worst enemy. Don't hate him because he's successful. Next question. Oh my god. John Bennett, thank you for the 5 gifted subs. You get, you're on the, can we put him in the top of the leaderboard, please? John Bennett, you're tied for first place with the rest of them. Thank you very much. Next question. Who was the first official Alveus collab? Oh, geez. I'm kidding. You cannot pay to win. He's not, that's a joke. It was a joke. Who was the first official Alveus collab? Was it Jack Manifold, Knut, Moist Critical, or Ludwig? I know all y'all are just copying each other. I know, I can tell. I can feel it in the way you're typing A. Hands up. I googled it. I copied this time. All right. If I start a 10 second countdown right now, am I giving mobile chatters enough time? Yes, right? Mobile chatters, you snooze, you lose. And by snooze, I mean watch on mobile. Australian chatters, you snooze, you lose. And by snooze, I mean live in Australia. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The first official collab at Alveus was Jack Manifold. And he came back to do another one. Fun fact. All right, leaderboard. Boogie Woogie with 50 points. Shut Up Leonard with 50 points. Both in first place. Strange Cyan moved up on the leaderboard, and Saucy McBossy and Crispy Minutes. Very nice. Very nice. All right, next question. The questions are getting harder, chat. What ambassador did not come from California originally? Reed? Was it Stompy? Was it Patchy? Or was it Georgie? Which ambassador did not come from California originally? I really thought that this one would get you. But it's not getting any of them because they're just copying. Guys, you need to put up your folders or something. Stop looking at each other's papers. Type with your eyes closed. Yeah, C for cheater. C for copier. 10, 9, 8, 7, six, five, four, three, two, one. Patchy did not come from California. Oh my God, that 82% of you did not know that. Admit if you didn't know that. Admit it. There's like 12 of you that knew that. All right. All right. 82%. Yes, Patchy came from Texas. Patchy did not come from California originally. The rest of them did. Shut up, Leonard. Oh, Boogie got that wrong. Shut up, Leonard's in first place. No, Boogie. He said, stop the count. Nice. Flexi moved into top 10. Jazz got moved into top 10. Very nice. Very nice, guys. Saucy McBossy just moved up quite a bit. Okay. The questions, again, are getting harder. You have two more questions. Are you ready? Alveus Chatters, might I recommend, if you're getting copied, just wait a little bit before you type your answer. Just don't type it so fast because you know it. Okay? Maybe just, like, wait a second. Instead of waiting. Last two questions are harder. Here we go. All right. 3, 2, 1, go. This is for the real ones. What ambassador had a swollen eye on Saturday? This past Saturday. You guys, what the hell? How are they doing that? I said, there was like, legitimately, there's gotta be like 600 of you that know that. From watching the Alveus cams, there has to be 600 max. All 600 of you typed it so fast, you guys need to slow down because everybody is copying you. They're copying you. It's typed slower. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The correct answer is jalapeno. Jalapeno got some dust in his eye or something. On 94% of you with 8,000 people here did not know that jalapeno's eye was swollen. Tell me who jalapeno is right now. Say what kind of animal he is, NMP chatters. Tell me. I don't even think you know what he is. They're lying. They don't. They're lying. They're liars. All right, there's one more question. It's actually hard. I thought that one would actually be hard. Now I'm confused. Shut up, Leonard is in first place with 70 points. He has a 20-point lead. That's actually big. That's big. Okay. The last question. Again, may I recommend that you take your time if you know the answer to this question? This one is not just four options. There's 10 options. 10 options. Will this set some people apart? Let's see. Which Alveus ambassador has been on antibiotics within the past 6 months? You have to be a live cam viewer for this because you would have to remember who, you'd have to remember at night when we go and give the animals antibiotics, who was getting the antibiotics. Toast, Winnie, Nilla, Moomin, Snork, Serrano, Finn, Oliver, Siren, or Chico? What do you think? Which ambassador has been on antibiotics within the past 6 months? What the hell? It's just hive mind, dude. This is like, someone should do a research on this. Okay. The correct answer is C. It's Nilla Wafer. She was on antibiotics for a respiratory infection. It's a rat. For those of you who don't know. But guessed correctly. Shut up, Leonard is it? Oh, wait. Is that refreshed? Yeah. Yes. Shut up, Leonard got that one wrong. Did you get that wrong? I thought you were at 70 points last time. Saucy McBossy moved up to second place along with Jazz, Fluxy, and Adurian, and Jateau, and Astru. Shut up, Leonard got it right. Weird. Boogie in eighth place. along with Crispy and Enf Simon. 8th, 9th, and 10th place with 50 points. We're going to move on to our next Olympic game, chat. This one, you might have a better shot in. I mean, you all had a good shot in that one, apparently. But we're going to move on to Pictionary. Can we cheat on this one, too? I mean, you can, but it's not a very good idea. I don't think it'll work. No, don't start guessing what it is. Guys, I haven't even started drawing. You are going to be guessing ambassador names. Might I remind you guys, today is Wednesday. Tomorrow is the rock party. If you come back to Nick's stream tomorrow and donate $50, we will paint your name on a rock. I have guys out there collecting and loading rocks in the back of trucks to bring to Nick Pollum's house right now. If you donate money, we will paint your name. Streamers will paint your username on a rock. We will seal them, and we will go put them in the new wolf enclosure at Alveus. Yay! And then if you come to my stream on Friday, I am doing a kickflip stream with Ricky Glasser, who is a professional skateboarder who has the world record for the amount of kickflips in 1 minute. And he's going to teach me how to do a kickflip. So come back on Friday for that. Okay. All right. Can we pick which streamer? No. But it will either be me, Nick, Melina, E-Rob, Cinna, Peach, Seer, Rune, Jeff, Russell, or Simply. Finn's cameramanning. Maybe Finn will do one. I don't know. I'm going to be honest. I didn't even invite Soda, but I don't think he would go. I could invite him, but I don't think he's going to go. Okay. Are you guys ready for Pictionary? Don't capital D colon me, okay? I know that Soda and I live in the same micro niche internet cinematic universe for y'all, but Soda and I have met each other, talked to each other like literally a handful of times. We don't know each other. I know to you, we're like all friends, like we're all in the same, but like, I don't know Soda, he doesn't know me. I think he'd be confused if I invited him. We like don't really hang out. I like him. It's not drama. I'm just saying. My immersion. No. Okay. Pictionary. The first person to write the animal's name, capitals do not matter, wins. First 10 people to guess the animal wins. Are you ready? You guys are pissing me off right now. All right, just go. Why aren't you guessing it? You don't think this is good? Giveaway. They got it. Whoppy got it first, then Baby, then Merger, Lord Viridian, MGI, Alex's Waterbender, Hoppers, IDK, What to Put, and Sunflower Seeds. Very nice. Very nice. How is he different to Tortellini? Well, if you were a real fan, you would know that I would draw Tortellini like this. Because he's pissed off all the time. Good job. All right. Shut Up Leonard is in the lead now with 80 points still, a 20-point lead. Saucy McBossy is in second place with Jazz Peru, Fluxy, Adurion, Jateau, and Astru. All right. We're looking about the same. Next up. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, go. Green Fox, Zenimo, Baby, Lord Viridian, Breezy. Good job, guys. Yes, it's Mia.
Peepa Pog, wow.
What do you think? What do you think? What do you think? Pretty good, huh? I don't know how to spell it. Are you serious? It's just like Maya, but even easier. Do we need to type their full legal names? You need to type their name. This one's a little tough. Because can they type their full legal name and their nickname or just... All right, this one is just their nickname. Are you ready? Seti, go. Toast! Boomsday! Dude, Baby Whatever has gotten a bunch of these. But I think the leaderboard's still looking the same. You got a ways to go if you want to catch up to these guys. It's Toast, the blue tongue skink. You're guessing the animals' names. If you need a refresher, you can check out the LVS website if you'd like. All right, I went down 5 places. No! Sad. I said it was their nickname. All right, next. Oh God, I don't know how to draw this. Next. What do you think? It's Momo. It's a toss-up. It could be Momo or Appa. But it's Momo. You can tell because of the way he is. Wait, there was a change in the leaderboard. Because Jateau got that in the top 10. Jateau is now in actual second place, dude. Shut up Leonard in first place with 80 points. Jateau was 70. Saucy McBossy was 60. And then Jazz and Fluxy and I'm Sevda moved up and Adurian and Astru. Nice, guys. Nice. We keep it. Watch this. We keep it moving. We keep it moving. All right. Next. Next. I'm not having fun anymore. That's what happens when you lose. Naughty, thank you for gifting 2 subs. Next. Leonard! Dude, he is gonna win. Dude, Leonard's crazy with it. Stolen Army, Corbid, Zeebo, Hossifilian, Fuji, Jazz, Catjack, Saya, and Aratzi. I always pick the wrong option. That's kind of fair. We have a lot of doubles. So, you don't really know. How you guys doing so far? Jazz and Jateau are now tied for second place. Leonard is in first place. With a 20-point lead still. Terrible. Sad. Devastated. God. The Olympics is supposed to be fun. What the heck? Shane, thank you for the gift. Thank you for the sub. I'm losing to Ping. That's what they all say. All right, I'm actually playing. You gotta say that to yourself. Are you ready?
Space, this is for you. Don't tell anyone. Put me behind Leonard in second place. Smile.
Oh, very interesting. Bribing the production manager. That will never work, gnome child. That will never work. There's no paying to win. But thank you for trying. That's what you think, hands up. All right, you guys ready? Three, two, one, go. Hold on. Type it again. What do you think of this drawing? KQ bingo bongo bango. Merger Alex's Icebound Wolf Leak 96 Roxer Lake and Star.
Actually put me in first place, please, thanks.
Cephalime just tipped $77.77 and said actually put me in first place. You know what? Yeah, let's give him 77 points, shall we? Cephalime, thank you so much. What the hell? He's paying to win. The answer was jalapeno. What do you mean, what was the answer? Did you see him? He was missing half of his ear. What do you mean, what was the answer? You didn't know who it was? It was a donkey. Ads, pay to win, baby. Why does Gnome Child have 69 points? Okay, get him out of there. It's because he paid the production manager. Gnome Child is not, that's not even a possible amount of points. All right. A few more. Are you guys ready? Space, are you ready? The corruption is out of control. I don't care if there's an ad, they're paying to win. Who's that? Who is it? Steve, Josh pre-typed. I saw it. Emin, Spooky, Captain, Kaylee, Coco, Luke, Amy, and Wob. The correct answer is Hank. Thank you for playing. Did that change the leaderboard? That is bread? No, it's not. You jebaited me, you absolute skull. Is that a slur? What did you just say to me? What the hell was that word? I've never seen that in my life. The leaderboard has not changed. There's a lot of 60s on there, though. Can I blame your draw? Can your drawings be better? I just need something.
Peepopog, wow.
Peepopog, wow.
What? Steve, you don't think my drawings are good enough? He didn't even have legs? I ran out of time. That was fully Marty. No, Marty would be like this, idiot. Smaller. Stupid. Okay, next one. Are you ready? 3, 2, One. That's a bird's eye view, baby. Scrotus. X Ashes, Wolf, Green Fox. Lording, Hunter, OK May, Moot, Normix, and Ren. Somebody just said you drew yourself. Okay, May got onto the leaderboard. Congratulations. Dude, you know what happens when men lose at games? You know what happens? They start calling women fat. Am I right or am I right? Chatter, you exposed yourself for being bad at games. You lose the Olympics. Okay, May, though, is killing it. Got on the leaderboard. Shut up, Leonard's still in first place. Jazz and Jateau are right on his heels. That's Georgie. That's Georgie. We have two more. Chat. Two more! Are you going to pull ahead? Let's see. Yeah, this guy. That guy. Are you going to pull ahead? Here we go. Three, two, one, go. A hint. A big hint. Coco, Alexa, that cat, Fuji, Cat, Jax, Matic, Bingle Bongle Bango, Lord Viridian, Pink, and guy from Ghana. Jateau moved down. Fuji moved up. Saucy McBossy still at 60 points. I'm sorry for activating your Alexa. Blame it on Alexa. This is Patchy. You can tell because she only has one eye. Duh. All right. One more. Yeah. Guys, this is multiple words. I'm not going to tell you how many. You know what? I'm going to make this one harder. It's multiple words, I'll tell you that. And I'm going to draw what the name is based off of and not the animal. Ready, set, go. Actually don't know how to draw that. It's because we said it's multiple words. They already knew. They already know. Congratulations. It's a push pop. It's a push pop, not a tampon. We got Scrotus, Mattson, Tana, Bat, Yibs, Wob, Mew, Josh, Aloe, Cat, Viva, Merger, and Alita. Josh hit the leaderboard. Congratulations. Jazz Peru with 70 points. Fuji with 70 points. Jateau with 70 points. Shut up, Leonard, still with 90. Pictionary's over. There's one more Olympic game.
Peepopog, wow.
We need more bug cams. Centipede, ant.
You're right. Oh my gosh. Ow. Ow! Football's hard. Do the top 10 win a cow? Top 10 get 10 points in each of these games. And the person that wins at the end wins first place. Did you break your hand? No, it's fine. See? It's fine. Guys, this is the final Olympic game, which we've moved way too fast. You want to do another round of Type Racer after this, perhaps? Yeah. I deleted some of the questions from the doc, but there might be some more in there. We can do Type Racer again after this game, because we have some time. All right. Did you break your face when you fell out of heaven? I don't know if that's an insult or a pickup line. I think it's an insult. Who's playing on the toilet right now? That's brave. Explains the forehead, maybe. Xano is really upset because I called him out for living in Australia. It's not my fault, buddy. All right. Are you guys ready for the last Olympic game before we do more Type Racer? You still have time to make it into the top 10. You still have time on the leaderboard. If you want to check your points, you can do command points. The last Olympic Games is two truths and a lie. Okay? You will type 1, 2, or 3 for what you think the lie is. Okay? They're about the animals. Are you guys ready? Yes, you'll type 1, 2, or 3. It's very, very crazy and brave of you to pre-type for this one, chat. You haven't even heard. It might be easy. You might actually have a shot at points here. The speed doesn't matter. Obviously. Okay. Well, do whatever you want. You ready, Space? All right, here we go. First, two truths and a lie. Again, guess 1, 2, or 3 for which you think the lie is. Statement number 1. Zebra isopods are native to South America.
Wow.
Statement number 2. Zebra isopods are in the same family as lobsters. Or number 3. Zebra isopods have 14 legs. Which one do you think is a lie? The people are guessing. Emotional support deck. Viking, thank you for gifting. Which one is the lie? I see a lot of people copying each other. And a lot of people guessing. Five, four, three, two, one. The lie, wait. 64% of people thought that it was 3, but the lie is 1. Zebra isopods are Mediterranean isopod. No. It's lit up yellow. All of you saying easy is so funny. It's lit up yellow because so many of you guessed that. That's the highest percentage. That's not the answer. Sean, thank you so much for the raid. Hello, welcome. Guys, we're doing chat Olympics right now. If you would like to join, please do. Hi, Sean. Yeah, actually debated. The lie is the first one. Zebra isopods are Mediterranean isopods. All right. Two truths and a lie, number 2. Are you ready? Again, guess which one you think the lie is. 1, 2, or 3. Statement number 1. macaws can scream at 130 decibels. Statement number two, macaws can fly at speeds over 50 miles an hour. Number three, macaws can live 50 to 70 years. Which one do you think the lie is? People are saying easy. People are saying easy. Somebody said, I said they were copying earlier, and someone was like, there's only three options. How can we not be copying? And the honest answer is, if you typed it after the very first person typed it and you typed the same answer, then it's copying. You're a cheater. Even if you didn't look at their answers because they already typed it. So I think this is a trick question. Interesting, interesting, interesting. Hmm. That is how two truths and a lie works, isn't it? Five, four, three, two, one. The lie is that macaws can fly at speeds over 50 miles an hour. Really, it's more like 30 miles an hour. 50 miles an hour would go crazy. 79% of you got that one correct. Congratulations. Let's look at the leaderboard. Let's look at the leaderboard. Any changes? Shut up, Leonard, in first place with 90 points still. Shut up, Leonard, in first place with 100 points. Jazz in second with Fuji with 90 points. Jateau and Merger with 80 points. Fluxy and Sevda and Alexis and Adurian and Roxer with 70 points. That's a lot of points, guys. That's crazy. Next, two truths and a lie. Are you ready to rumble? I just joined Maya. Restart. Guys, should we restart for that guy? You want to go back to the beginning? You want to start from the first game? Reset all the points? Yeah? Okay. Okay, next one. Two truths and a lie. Guess one, two, or three, which one you think the lie is. Statement number one. Here we go. African bullfrogs are the second largest frog species in the world. Georgie's species is also sometimes called pixie frogs. Or Georgie's favorite food is mice. One, two, or three, which is the lie? It's a tough one, guys. It's a tough one. Cephalime?
Four.
What? I've never heard him say that. I don't even know why you said that. Okay. All right, let's see the results. Most 54% of you thought the answer was, thought the lie was the second statement. Wrong. The lie is the third statement. Georgie's favorite food is super worms, dum-dums, not mice. His favorite food is super worms. It's always been super worms. Oh, shit. Shut up, Leonard, Jazz, and Fuji are now all tied with 100 points. Jetto in second place with 90 points. This is a triple threat match. Two more two truths and a lie. Are you ready? Three, two, one, go. Statement number one. Marmosets are from Madagascar. Statement number two. Marmosets are in the same family as lemurs. Statement number three. Marmosets love to eat tree sap. Where are marmosets from? What family are they in? And what do they love to eat? Which one is the lie? All of the above. No. Only one of them is a lie. That's the whole game. It's called Two Truths and a Lie. What the hell is a marmoset? Thank you for staying this long. Opa and Momo. All right. Which one of these is the lie? Statement number one is the lie. Marmosets are not from Madagascar. Marmosets are from Brazil. 74% of you got that right. Does that change the leaderboard? No, it doesn't. They are neck and neck, dude. Shut Up Leonard, Jazz Peru, and Fuji all with 110 points. Jateau with 100 points. I did not see any wild marmosets now. I wish I'd go crazy. We have one more two truths and a lie, and it is a tough one. And it is about Winnie the Moo. Everybody's favorite baby cow. Are you ready? Statement number one. About 70% of our world's freshwater usage is in agriculture. Statement number two. The largest stomach that a cow has is called the rumen. Statement number three. Cows were domesticated over 15,000 years ago. Which one is the lie? Is it running space? No. Oh, it's not on screen. Which one is the lie? About 70% of our world's freshwater usage is in agriculture. The largest stomach a cow has is called the rumen, or cows were domesticated over 15,000 years ago. Which one is the lie? I domesticated the first cow, so I know.
Peepapug, wow.
But Derry's only 24 years.
Avocado, thank you for the 3 months. That's okay that you think that. It's fine. Pull up the Kahoot theme for this John. Using John like that is funny. I should start doing that. You walk into a bar. Check out the vibes in this John. What a funny thing to say. Okay. Which one of these is the lie? Three, two, one. The lie is that cows were domesticated over 15,000 years ago. 73% of you got that correct. Cows were domesticated about 10,000 years ago. It was a bit of a tricky one. Good job, guys. View the leaderboard! Who's in the lead? Ah! Three are in the lead. Shut up, Leonard. Jazz and Fuji and Jato is at 110 points. Roke Sir is in third place with 100 points, tied with Wob, tied with Merger. What does the winner get? First place! Do you have any type racer questions? Okay. Guys, we're going to do... Do you want me to send you some over Discord? Guys. Add all the symbols. This is not the question. Okay. I need to write spaces for you guys to type, and we're going to do Type Racer. Stand by. I'm writing three questions. Stand by. I'm gonna do five, actually. We can do five. No, I'm not. That's not the type. No, that's too long. That's too long. All right, I have typed five sentences. Are you guys ready for Type Racer? This is the end of Chat Olympics. This is your last chance to make it on the leaderboard and potentially win the Chat Olympics. Jato is, yes. Jato is mad. Jato said, no, this is stupid. You have to be good at chat. You have to be good at Type Racer if you want to win the Chat Olympics, okay? It's one of the four games. It's important. Here's how Type Racer works, okay? There will be a sentence that shows up on screen and you will type it in chat. Caps matter. Punctuation matters. Spelling matters. The first 10 people to type the sentence correctly will get 10 points. There are five sentences. Don't give up already. You haven't even seen the sentences. The first one is very easy. Are you ready? Space, are you ready? 3, 2, 1, go. The sentence is, The sentence is, Georgie is my king. Capitalization matters. Periods matter. They already did it. The Hamco, Flexi, Shut Up Leonard, Chick, Star, Josh, Fuji, Captain, Alexis, Warsome. Let's see the leaderboard. Flexi might have moved up. Yeah, Jazz moved down. Because Fuji moved up. Fuji and Shut Up Leonard are tied in first place. Jazz is in second. Jateau is in third. Four more sentences for Type Racer. Are you ready? Am I washed? I have not seen you on the leaderboard a single time today, except for that one time, but not on this leaderboard. So yes, you are washed. Second sentence, are you ready? Type fast, type accurately.
I have dyslexia. This is ableist. When is the chat Paralympics?
You can use speech to text if you want. Okay, 3, 2, 1, oh, go. Connor's full legal name is Custard the Clown. Capitalization matters, spelling matters. Apostrophes matter. They're doing it.
Beeple Pug, wow.
Male, thank you for the 4 months. Spence, Bluebird, Titmouse, Little, Splash. You guys might have broken it. You're typing too fast. You broke it. Saucy. 90s. Space is getting the actual winners. Stand by. Maya, I've switched to computer. Good for you. I respect the grind. I respect that you're taking this so seriously. It's very important. The prize could really change your life. Stand by. We're having technical fixes. Technical difficulties. They're getting fixed. I put an Ethernet cord in for this. That's hilarious. That's so funny.
Beeple Pug, wow.
Respect Hot. The grind. Full plaid, thank you for the 6 months. All right, here are the actual winners. We got Hamco, Enf, Simon, Zello, Zashes. I don't think that's how it's said. Flash, Divicious, Vast, Danny, Nick, Knack, and Let Moose. Top 10 here. Sorry, Spence. Leaderboard. You have 3 more. Three more sentences. Is this the leaderboard?
Yeah.
Okay, so it hasn't changed. Oh, Lord Viridian made it on there. Nice. All right. Next question, guys. Make sure to plug that Ethernet cable into your phones if you're on mobile. It helps you go faster. If it doesn't fit in there, just push it in. It'll work. All right. Sentence number 3. Capitalization matters. 3, 2, 1, go. Hassan is Winnie the Moo's favorite streamer. Man, you guys are fast. It's broken. Chat, you're breaking it! Favorite is not spelled wrong. It's spelled in American. Hold. 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 Don't get too excited if you're on there. Yeah, it's probably wrong. Sorry. Sorry. Should we toss this one then? We're going to toss this one because it's broken. Space is going to restart the bot. Stand by. You guys are too good at type racer. It's actually kind of crazy. You guys type really fast. I could not do that. I'd be too stressed. My hands would be like shaking. Are you guys' hands shaking? Are your hands sweaty? Guys, wipe off your hands. Okay? They're all wet. Gross. My fingers are bleeding. I already lost, so no pressure. Oh, saved. That's the best, right? That's the best.
Peepapug, wow.
We can just do the last one if it's working. You want to do one more? Like the very last sentence.
Peepapug, wow.
Some dumb beach. Thank you for the prime. Luck, thank you for the prime. Okay, we are going to do one more type racer, okay? We're going to do one more type racer. Hopefully you don't break the bot. This is the last game of Chat Olympics. Understand? This is the last Chat Olympics game. Three, two, one, go. I admit that I lost the Chat Olympics because I am bad at games. This is way too much power. Zello, Emph Simon, Low Road. TL Josh, Let Moose, The Hamco, Shut Up Leonard, Edurion, Saucy, and Flash Fearless. Dude, Leonard getting that was actually so clutch. The leaderboard, final refresh. We have our winner. Shut Up Leonard in first place with 140 points. Fuji in second place with 130 points. Jazz Peru with 120. Jateau with 110. Fluxy with 100. Alexis, Adurion, Roxer, Wob, and Merger all with 100 points. You can check your points if you do command points if you'd like to. Martin, thank you for the sub. Shut Up Leonard, congratulations. Congratulations, you win. First place. Someday when your son's older and he wants to know what his dad accomplished in his life, you can tell him I won the Chat Olympics on April 3rd, 2024 on twitch.tv/Maya. What did you win, Dad? First place, son. Incredible. That's incredible. I won the win. That's the spirit. Speech. Shut up, Leonard. Please give a speech. Speech. I have to thank my 5 years of degenerate chatting for this victory. Feel strong, man. Oh, it's beautiful. That was beautiful. Can we get some glorps and olorps for Shut Up Leonard? All rise for Shut Up Leonard. This is the best day of his life, barring the day that his son was born. And the day that he got married. If you're married, I don't even know. All right. Excellent job, guys. Your participation today was incredible. Stream is not over. I have to pee. And then I will be back. And then we're going to my house.
Peep-a-pug, wow.
Dark Souls. Thank you for the prime. Guys, I'm going to pee really quick and then we're going to be back. Connor, do you have anything to say to them?
You're welcome. What's the other one? I don't remember the giga. I don't remember any of them. Hello. Custard is dead. Custard's never coming back. Ever. Ever. Baby shark. Georgie liked it. Space loves it. The only thing that will live from custard is this. It's kind of fun. I like annoying Space and Maya with it. DMCA incoming, for sure, for sure. Penis man. I don't know. I love the nickname, love it. What did I eat for breakfast? Hearts and souls, that's what I ate. Play Pokemon theme song. I was trying like Naruto and stuff like that, but never got to it. Guys, wolves. Do I have updates? They're building a big 30 by 30 right now. It's beautiful. And it's going to be made out of steel. Same people that made the foxes is making the indoor enclosure for the wolves. So it's great. Hey, Maya, did it hurt? She said, did what hurt? When you fell from heaven because your face is fucked up.
No, I need HR. Ah, shit, Connor's HR.
I can say that because I'm HR.
No, that's not how that works. Don't say that. All right. Well, guys, Darion, you missed football practice. Dude, I'm on your football team. Look what happened to me.
I love Darion.
Can you tell? This lighting makes it look so chill. I know. I feel like it does look worse in person, but my whole hand's all bruised up. You can see it on my Twitter. I'll be there next Sunday. Oh, I won't be.
Yeah, you will.
No, I won't. I'm not going to be there, but I did hurt my hand. What? It's not a game. It's just practice.
Yeah, you better be there.
No, I can't. I'm not going to be here. I'm going to be at the Ren Fair.
What time?
All day, baby.
That's lame. Wait.
No, it's not. Darion, I learned how to play football, though, and I heard that you're my quarterback. Is that what football players do?
Wow.
Yes, sir, I will run a route, sir. Yes, sir, Mr. Quarterback, sir. I would like a touchdown, please. Darion, here's the strap for our team. Here's what happens. This is Darion. This is everybody else. Don't worry about how many there are. This is me. Okay? Darion, can you zoom in? This is Darion, this is me. Darion, here's our strat. Okay? First of all, oh, it's broken.
I shocked it. It'll be back in a second.
Connor shocked the camera, so it stopped working. It's...
Is it still dead?
What do you mean you shocked the camera? What does that mean?
I have a lot of electricity.
I've never seen that happen ever.
Static electricity. Maybe I broke it completely. Oh, shit.
Connor, what happened? What? Oh my god.
I thought I broke it.
Darion. Okay, listen to me. Here's our team. Here's you as the quarterback. Here's me as the
wide receiver.
Tight end. Wide receiver. I'm the wide receiver. It's a 50-50. Here's me as the wide receiver. Nobody's gonna expect me to do anything, right? Nobody's gonna expect me to do anything. And no one's gonna expect me to be fast. And everybody else is faster, in fairness. These are all the guys, right? All the guys, they think they're so fast. They go go routes. They go, 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 go. Me? No. Me, they go fast. I go here, and I do an in route. Oh, and then they're all up here, and I'm right here. And everybody's going to leave and follow these guys. They're going to cover these guys because they're like, oh, they're going to get touchdowns. No one's going to think that I'm going to do anything. And then I'm going to do an in route. You know, I'm going to receive it right here. And then I'm going to run. Touchdown. No one's going to see it coming. Alternatively, I could also do a comeback. Everybody's over here. Everybody's like, oh, it's time to go to the end zone. Time to go to the end zone to get a touchdown, not me. No one's going to stay with me. I'm going to come here. I'm going to do a comeback. I can receive it here. And I can go, what? Touchdown. What do you think? Only works once. Not if you ask nicely. I'll just say, hey, can you please not cover me? I'm going to do a comeback and then I'm going to run. So you'd be in my way if you... She's got manners, baby. That goes a long way. Are they allowed to tackle you? They would never do that to me. No, it's not tackle football. Dude, Darion's on my team. Imagine me playing tackle football with guys like Darion on my team. What? That is insane. I would never do that. It's flag football. So then I'll just be like, hey, excuse me, please don't take my flags. They're mine. That'd be sick. Dude, I got pink gloves.
Wow.
Yeah, it's kind of sick. I got plays too. I drew them up. Cool. And we'll be ready to go. Okay. Anyway, that's a strat, Darion. See you there. Guys, we're going to go to my house. Are you ready? Are you ready, Space?
Yeah.
We're going to go to my house. I'm going to leave you on this camera. I just have to drive up there, but I'm going to take you with a mic. Okay? Field trip, except it's just an audio field trip. You're going to stay here, but then we're going to switch over and it's going to be like you teleported. And then you'll be in my house.
Okay. Can I hear you?
Testing. Testing. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
Okay. But check this out. I'm going to my car. Testing. Testing, talking. Testing, talking. I'm testing and I'm talking. I'm testing and I'm talking. I'm testing. I'm testing and I'm talking. It's not delayed. Shut up.
skill issue. It's a ping issue. You're all Australian. That's your problem. We're getting in Binky Bonky. Did you bring your permission slips? Yes or no? Binky Bonky, do-do-do-do-do-do. I'm going to my house. I need to boot up my PC. Oh, I just saw a glimpse of the thing by the barn, and it looks like poop, literally. It literally looks like poop. What is Connor doing? Excuse me, Mr. Contractor Truck, sir. I need to get by. Thank you. What is Connor doing? He drew a plane. Hi, Bella. Hi, Maddie. I like planes. House. I'm booting up my PC. I'm putting my headset on. I'm turning the light on. I'm turning my camera off and then back on again. I'm opening OBS. I'm switching the profile to should I do LVS Studio? I'm starting stream. No, I'm stopping stream. I'm changing it to RTMP. I'm starting stream. I'm ready to swap. I slam the door. I hey. I made it to my house. I teleported. I told you I would. I told you I would. La la. Ooh. Finally cut you off. I feel so much lighter, like a feather with you off my mind. My. Easy peasy. How'd you like the audio podcast? What'd you think? The tiny house video? I have no idea. Like months, probably. I think it's
It's called Tiny House Big Journey or something. Why is everybody asking that? So random. Oh, is it because I'm in my house? All right. Whoa, that's loud, huh? Peak test. That's fine. I feel so much lighter like a feather with you on my mind. Stand by. I'm tweeting. Oh, Tiny House Giant Journey. That sounds right. Sorry, I don't know. I don't remember. All caps. Tweeting. Sorry. Tweeting. Tweeted. Done. Great. All right. Cool. Okay, folks. I'm sponsored by AT&T today. Hello, welcome to the second portion of my stream here. I am sponsored today, again, by AT&T. You guys already know how it is. Yes, we freaking love AT&T. You know what it is. AT&T is shining a spotlight on the best up-and-coming creators on the entire Twitch platform through their Class of program, which began in 2021. There have been, the way it works is there's mentors and there's mentees. I'm a mentor for this year. Other mentors have been Cypher PK, Botez Sisters, Hafu, Lil Simsy, Aiden TP, Extra Emily. So it's cool that I get to be a part of that this year. And there are mentees who are emerging creators, well-deserving streamers who have grinded their way to get here. And AT&T is helping them pair with mentors to help develop their skills to grow their communities on Twitch, which is pretty cool. Pretty cool. AT&T is helping those streamers through promotions on Twitch's homepage, incorporation into custom commercials, and raids from other mentors. Myself. Wahoo. With the support of AT&T's power and their technology, along with Twitch's expertise in content creation, AT&T will set each Class of member on the path to success and help make their streaming dreams a reality. Cool. Also, that noise is mushroom. My ferret. Oh, was that a rat? Do you hear him? No. Also, AT&T has fiber. Check to see if AT&T has fiber available in your area. Sign up now and get up to $150 in rewards cards. They'll also cover your cancellation fee in full. You can do command ATT fiber, I believe. Now delivering up to 5 gig speeds. Check if AT&T fiber is available in your area. There's a link in chat to earn more. You can earn $150 reward by signing up online. Hooray. Cool. Okay, party people. Great. So, if you guys are here from my stream earlier, if you were watching my stream earlier, I did the Chat Olympics today. What'd you guys think? What'd you think? Did you have fun? The first ever Twitch Chat Olympics, Alveus edition. Was fun. Don't say it was rigged. Don't say it was scammed. People were cheating. It was rigged. Okay. The people that are saying that people were cheating and that it was rigged are just upset that they didn't win. But yes, I did. I did Chat Olympics today. And I'm sponsored by AT&T today, and I'm going to tell you guys how I did that today. Kind of like the boomerang stream that we did, where I explained what happened. I'm going to explain this stream and give you guys my streaming insights, my streaming knowledge for how we did that today. Will you do that again? It was the non-annual first and last Chat Olympics. Actually, I do kind of want to do that for summer camp. I think it'd be really fun. I think we can do it again for summer camp. My thumb is not hurt from the boomerang. It's hurt from football. It still doesn't look that bad on camera. Camping. Thank you very much. Okay. So, one of the things that I wanted to do as part of this AT&T program is show some of the things that I enjoy doing most on stream. One of those things, the first one that I did was the boomerang, where I did an IRL stream. Also, I know this is not normal, and I know it might make you uncomfortable. I'm sorry. I have to look into the camera. I just feel like I need to warn y'all, because I never look into the camera, but I have to look into it. So just be ready to stare, okay? Okay. So, I wanted to talk about some of the things that I think are most fun with streaming. And the first thing was IRL streaming, which is why I went out and I did the boomerang stream. And then I talked to you guys about how I did the boomerang stream, right? It was like how to find your location, how to test your location, how to do the research to do it, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. One of the other things that I think is really fun about, or with streaming, is incorporating chat. You guys, I like incorporating chat. I just think it's a really fun way to keep people super engaged when the chat is moving really fast. It usually feels like a better stream when you have a dead chat. It's like really sad and doesn't feel very good. So, and it's fun for you guys to be super engaged in a stream. I think it's a good time. And it's a good way to test your knowledge, especially on things like the animals. How good of a listener are you? How good of a student are you? Are you good enough to win? That's not really the point, but it was the point today, okay? So I have tips for what I did today, the Chat Olympics today. If you're a streamer and you want to do the Chat Olympics, here's my first tip. Number one, know your demographic on your platform. So for me, my demographic is obviously y'all. I know that you guys are generally, correct me if I'm wrong, I know you guys are generally between like 18 and like 35. And Twitch is primarily men because it's traditionally a gaming site. So it's mostly men on there. But it's mostly young adults. I'm 38. I'm 73. I'm 26. I'm 39. I'm 300. Okay. So anyway, knowing your demographic is really important because it's important to know what they'll be interested in, right? Like what kind of things that they'll enjoy. For example, would a 70-year-old man enjoy competing in Type Racer? Definitely not. Why? Because 73-year-old men type very slowly and with one finger on each hand. You guys like typing really fast. And so I knew that you would like Type Racer. I think it's really fun. Some 73-year-old men type really fast. I don't know. But most of the 73-year-old men that I know type really slow. So they wouldn't like it. It's important to know your demographic when you're incorporating chat, obviously. My second tip is repeat what works. I have done incorporating chat features in a lot of my streams, and some of them work really well, and some of them don't work really well. I think the favorite incorporating chat elements that I've ever incorporated in my stream was when I did the conservation cast and I used the quiz kit, which doesn't work at this scale for me, but I used to do a quiz where I would test people on the whole podcast, like the whole stream, the whole conversation that we were having, and then they would have to answer the quiz questions to see how well they were listening, and then they could win the quiz, and they like won points for the quiz. People loved doing that. It kept them engaged for the whole stream because it gave them a reason to listen to it. And then at the end of the stream, they could test their knowledge and get points, and it was just fun. They're not winning anything. They just like participating. So the quiz kit was always really fun. So that's part of why I incorporated the second Olympic game today, which was the lore quiz, the Alveus lore quiz. So yeah, what the heck? You're like a teacher quizzing people after a video? That's exactly right. Yeah. So that's why I did the lore quiz today, because it modeled after the quiz kit thing. I've used the first person to type model before as well. So for Type Racer, I also, Type Racer is also just something that I've done on stream. I know it's something that people have fun doing. It is like one of the easiest games you can play on a PC, if it's even considered a game, and everybody knows what it is. So it's something that the demographic all knows. Everybody knows what Type Racer is. And then you can go in there and Space wrote the bot to be able to have people be able to type it in chat, because obviously we couldn't do it in the browser because we would just destroy the browser. So Type Racer, very fun. And then Pictionary I've done before as well. And that's really fun because it's super interactive with me and the chat, because I can draw something and then they can watch and then they can guess what it is. So yeah, repeat what works. Tip number three, I kind of wish that Space was here to help me explain all this, but prepare your tech. Make sure you have the ability to achieve your ideas on your own, or the tech support to manage the ideas that you have. I do not write bots. I'm not a programmer. I do have a lot of ideas, and Space is my production manager and my behind the scenes guy who does all of that for me. So essentially, I can go to Space and I can be like, can we do this? Can we have chat do this? Can we have chat say this? And then Space tells me if that's a possibility or not. So Space is able to write these bots. They're bots, most of them that we did today were already written because we've used them before in the past and they've worked in the past. So it made it really, really easy. But the first thing is having the ideas. And the second thing is having somebody that can make those ideas come to life if you can't make those ideas come to life yourself. But Space is a goat. I would not be live ever without Space. We know this. Tip number four, be flexible. When you're incorporating chat, it's a giant entity, a giant body of a bunch of random people, and you don't know what's going to happen. And so you have to be ready to change your plan if it doesn't work out as the way that you thought, or things change, or things happen differently. Today, I made those four Olympic games thinking that it would take up a full 2 hours, but it didn't. So then at the end, we had to do impromptu extra Type Racer to fill up the time, which is easy because it's already a written bot and all I had to do was write questions on the fly. But the whole thing went by a lot faster than I expected, so I had to be ready to do extra stuff. And that's why we did more Type Racer at the very end of the stream today. Very important to be flexible, and very important to be able to adjust in real time because you're live. Those are the tips that I have for you guys on the stream that I did today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. It was a good time. I definitely want to reuse all of these incorporating chat ideas for summer camp, and other events, but that was our idea today. Okay, I'm gonna stop looking at you right now. Was that uncomfortable for you? I'm gonna explain those again in a bit. Sorry. Sorry. Yeah, I think it'd be really fun. We could do like a really long version of that for summer camp, because summer camp is actually, last year we talked about moving it to be more of a, or making it a 12-hour stream instead of a 24-hour stream. Because 24 hours was so long last year. But we could make like a longer one for summer camp. I think that'd be fun. It's also very hot during summer camp. That's also true. Dude, why? What is with... Is that one guy talking about Tarek? Sorry, it's unrelated. I'm trying to focus right now. Why do people keep asking me about Tarek? What is going on today? 24 hour again, but more incentive. I don't know. We'll figure it out. We'll figure it out. I don't do eye contact. I actually looked away from the screen. I'm so sorry. It's the same guy. Oh. Okay. So I had the boomerang IRL. I have this. And then I'm also, the third stream that I'm going to do with this like model is a green screen. Which I'm kind of nervous about. I actually didn't think about until I just said that out loud, that giving you guys a whole 3 hours of green screen is really scary. I hadn't thought about that. But I was going to do a green screen because we're doing animal defense behaviors, right? So like the animal reproduction streams that I've done, except we're doing, oh right, you won't have a green screen. The animal reproduction stream that I did, except we're doing cool defense behaviors instead. So it'll be fun. That'll be fun. But today was, honestly, we've had so much going on in April. Today was relatively, it wasn't last minute, but it was something that Space really put together in a day, and I put together in a day, and I had Shrez write a bunch of those questions yesterday. And it worked out really well, actually. I think the stream today was super smooth. I think it was really fun. I think it's something that I want to do more of. I know you guys have fun when you can, like, type stuff and interact with stuff. So I think it's a good time. But it worked really well, and it was really smooth because all of those things were already built because we've used them before. Like, we know that stuff like that works. We know that it's fun for you guys. I will say, I was not expecting an NMP raid this morning. I think if I knew that I was going to get such a big raid, I probably wouldn't have made it Alveus themed. I think it made for a big advantage for the real ones, but I think it made a lot of people leave because they're like, I don't know, I don't care. But if it was like just straight up animal themed or something, I think a lot more people would have stayed, but I just wasn't expecting a raid. So I don't know. I watch your streams for the animals. Respect. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I am sponsored by AT&T today, guys. They have a class of program began in 2021 where they've featured more than 75 up-and-coming creators and paired them up with mentors like Cypher PK, Extra Emily, the Botez sisters, Lil Simsy, It's Hafu, and myself. And it's helping to elevate creators by putting them on the front page, incorporating them into custom commercials, and getting them raids from mentors. I'm a mentor, so I will be raiding one of the mentees today. Very fun. And the hope is that AT&T will set up each class of member on the path to success, help their streaming dreams become a reality. You know, they've been grinding at it for a long time. I've met a few of these mentees in person. They're really, really awesome. Yeah, it's cool that you guys can check them out through me and AT&T. AT&T also has fiber. You can check to see if AT&T fiber is in your area. You can sign up now and get up to $150 in reward cards. They'll also cover your cancellation fee in full. You can do command ATT fiber. And it's now delivering up to 5 gig speed, so you can see if it's available in your area. There's a link in chat to learn more. You can earn up to $150 rewards by signing up online. Man, ATT fiber. Sweet. Excellent. We have been partnered with AT&T for a few weeks now. It's a really sick sponsor for me. This is not really a part of it, but I have said this in the past a lot. I love having sponsors that give you the ability to go out and do things that you would on your normal stream. You know, like the boomerang stream was such a stream that I would just do. And then this stream is such a stream that I would just do. And then the last hour is just like explaining it through AT&T. They're really just trying to elevate creators. It's very cool of them. Some sponsors don't make it this easy to like create good content. And AT&T really does. So I really appreciate that. about them. It's been really fun to do these. And then the next stream, well, it's every Wednesday, if you guys have noticed that, right? The last one, the last stream I did, the goat seesaw. I did the goat seesaw, and that was sponsored by AT&T. And they're just like, yeah, goat seesaw, great. Which is awesome. So they really get it. They really get like what it takes for streamers to be successful, and they want them to be successful, which is really, really great. We love that. We love that. Sponsors that promote creativity, W. Is anybody here from the front page? AT&T also put me on the front page today. Every Wednesday. What the heck? So cool. Are you nervous about tomorrow? No. W. Me smile. You guys are all lying. I know none of you are front pagers because I can see that you're not first time chatters. I can tell that you're lying. First time here, front page brought me here. Yeah, right. Oh, we got a first time chat. Oh, look. Oh, wow. Actual front pagers. Wahoo. Hello, welcome everybody to the stream. Thanks for being here. If you're not familiar with my channel, hello, my name's Maya. Nice to meet you. I am the founder and executive director of an animal sanctuary and conservation education center in Austin, Texas. We have crows, we have parrots, we have foxes, we have monkeys, we are rescuing wolves, we have reptiles, we have bugs, we have chickens, we have an emu, we have a cow, we have donkeys, we have chinchillas, we have rats, we have a tortoise. We have a bunch of animals here. And we curate educational programming around the rescued animals. All of them are non-releasable. We curate conservation programs around these animals, and then I do the conservation programs online to Twitch to teach you guys about animals. So if you guys want to see the animals, they're live 24/7 on the Alvea Sanctuary channel on Twitch. Or if you want to follow this channel, awesome. You will see them on my channel every single week, all the time. You'll see them all the time. They're very cool. Yeah, Winnie's a cow. We do have rats. Yeah, my goal is to get conservation messaging to as many people around the world as possible. Get as much conservation messaging to as many people as possible. That is the dream. So if you like animals and you like nature and wildlife and our natural world, would appreciate a follow. Thank you very much. Soybeans, thank you for the sub. Appreciate that. Brain Hurts, thank you for the 5 gifted subs. Thank you. Yes, tomorrow we have a fundraiser for the sanctuary. Yes. Hold on. Can I make a bet with you? Probably not. Okay. Probably not. I don't like making bets. It stresses me out. Hello, welcome from the homepage. Wahoo, I believe you. Alrighty. Cool. Wait, please, it's for the rock party? Okay, go ahead, chatter. I will let you go ahead. What do you got? Waiting. Waiting. Good thing this guy wasn't playing Type Racer. What? He said, if you can say my name 10 times fast, 5 times, I get a free rock. What kind of bet is that? That is a terrible deal. Absolutely not. Actually, because your suggestion was so bad, you are required to purchase a rock tomorrow. Everybody hold that chatter accountable. For wasting all y'all's time. And mine. Alright. He said fine. Let's go. Respect. Thank you. He's gonna buy a rock. Okay. Alright, guys. Shall we run it back one more time? Should we run it back one more time, just in case you didn't hear me talk about it earlier? I gotta look in the camera. I gotta be ready. Everybody prepare yourselves. Great. All right, here we go. I am sponsored by AT&T today. Today's topic is incorporating chat, which is one of my favorite things to do on my streams. And I have some tips for you. Tip number one. Know your demographic and know your platform. You gotta know who you're talking to. On Twitch, it's like 18 to 35 year old, mostly men because it's a gaming site. So you gotta cater to the boys. You gotta cater to the gaming boys. And you gotta know that you're on Twitch. So you're live. What can you do in real time with chatters? For me, today, I did Chat Olympics, which meant that I did polls. I did quiz questions. I played Pictionary. And I did Type Racer, where they were typing in chat to win points, and we had a leaderboard, and we kept track of their points the whole stream, and then the winner won. Excellent. Tip number two, repeat what works. If you've done it before, that's not just for yourself either. If you've done it before and it's worked on your stream, great. If you've seen other people do it before, other streamers do it before, no shame. Take it. If you've seen other streamers do it before and it works really well and you think you can put your own spin on it and use it for your stream and you think it would work, great. It's very fun. Everybody can share ideas. Great. You can do whatever you want. I've never done Type Racer before, but I have done quizzes before. I've done lots of polls before on my stream, so I know those things work. The bots for those are written, so we made sure to use them again. Tip number three, prepare your tech. If you don't know how to write bots, and if you don't know how to program, then you can find someone who does. And then you just have to have the really good ideas, and you can ask them if they can help you bring your ideas to life. Luckily, Twitch is a place where a lot of people know how to use computers. A lot of people are on PCs, so there are a lot of people that know how to program. There might be someone in your chat who knows how to do that. I don't know. Ask around. Or you could write your own bots if you're crazy and really smart and really good at it. I don't know how to write my own bots, but I do have a production manager who programs, and I'll tell him, this is my idea, is this possible? And he'll say yes, and then he'll write it, and then we can use it for chat. Excellent. Great. Great. Tip number four, be flexible. If you're incorporating a chat, you don't know how big it is. I got a raid today for over 8,000 people. I wasn't expecting them. It broke one of our bots. Tragic. You never know how fast chat's gonna move. You never know if they're gonna get bored and you have to move on to another game. Today, they blew through all of my games a lot faster than I thought, and then we had to add another round of Type Racer at the end of my stream to make sure that the stream was long enough because we were going 2 hours. So you have to be ready to incorporate your chat or to adjust in real time and to be flexible. Incorporate chat on the fly. Keep your head on a swivel. Be ready to make changes. It's an important part of live streaming. So be ready with like backup plans. I should have had extra Type Racer sentences written because I know better and I know that I should be flexible and be ready to adjust on the fly in real time. I did not have questions ready, but you can be better than me and you can have questions or you can have sentences written so you can do more Type Racer at the end of your stream to fill time and to stall. I wrote them while I was live, but it still worked. We also, because we had so many more viewers than we thought, broke the bot of the type racer, so we only got to do one more, so then I just had to stall longer. It is what it is. It happens. Those are my tips. Get out there, get streaming. Thank you, AT&T, for sponsoring. New Gator, you just subbed, and I saw that. Thank you so much, and thank you so much for those crocheted parrots. I lost my mind over them. It's probably the coolest thing I've ever gotten in the P.O. Box. Incredible. You're so talented. And I don't think you were there yesterday, so thank you so much. How do you usually stall? It depends on what I'm doing, I guess. I can talk. I'm a streamer. I can just yap, dude. I can yap, man. I could talk for hours without having anything to say. But I'm a streamer and a podcaster, so it's my job to yap. I'm a big yapper. You gotta get used to yapping. A lot of it's recycling stories. Or you can read chat. You have a whole live chat. You have people saying stuff. Just be like, hey, what's your favorite color? And then you wait for them to type their favorite color. And then you pick one of them. And then you tell them, why, state, thank you for the 10 months. We're here for the yapping. Thank you for the tier one. Jazz said red is his favorite color. And then you tell him why he's wrong. Actually, Jazz, your favorite color is not red. It's yellow. Chat, do you remember last week when Jazz was literally in the Alveus chat and said, guys, my favorite color is yellow? And everyone was like, okay, cool. Nobody asked. Yep. I remember that too. And now he's in here saying that his favorite color is red. That's bizarre. Oh, actually, he remembers. Respect. What is gaslighting? I don't know. I've never gaslit anybody before. Hold. Never mind. Actual professional stalling techniques. Thanks for the live demonstration. You're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome. So, anyway. That was pretty much... I mean, we have some time. We have some time to chat. And I'm going to go over some AT&T stuff throughout the rest of the stream. But... yeah. For being just like a normal weekly stream that kind of came out of nowhere. Because I know you guys didn't even know that was going to happen until a couple days ago. I think it went really well. I feel really good about it. Yes, I see your chat. I will say, though, if your name's Dark Blue, it's really hard to see you against a dark mode background. Like, I can't read your name. Dark Blue is probably the worst color on night mode. Sorry. Any Dark Blue chatters? Question from a follower. How do you wear earrings and headphones at the same time? That's a great question. It is not comfortable. It's not worth it. Wouldn't recommend. Wow, so many Dark Blue chatters. Hello, Peach. Hello. I saw you text me. I haven't read it yet, though. I'm going to read it right when I get offline. First thing. NMP is not showing up today. I'm going to NMP's tomorrow. Peach is going to be there tomorrow, too, for a fundraiser. You can still see my name. Yeah. I don't know what color Dark Row is, but it's not that. Dark Row's color is fine. It's Ace Desert. I can't even read their name. It said first time in and I already love the stream. That's very nice. It's that color though. I like can't read the username. I feel bad. Okay, Shrez just said this and said, what's up, brother? What is that like a boy thing? Why do I keep seeing that online and I don't know what it is? Cinderheart, thank you for the 32 months. What is that? Why do boys keep doing that? Ow. It's a TikTok meme. Okay. Oh, it's a Jinxie meme, really? A streamer named Sketch. What does Sketch do? It's a streamer name. Yes, I get. Plays Madden? Zoomer memes and Madden. Interesting. I could play Madden for sure. I know a lot about Madden because I know a lot about football. Stores, thank you for the bits. Cinderheart, thank you for the sub. State, thank you for the sub. Big Bird, thank you for the sub. Appreciate that. You're getting better and better at creating content. That's a very nice thing to say and very random. What the heck? What a nice guy. Thoughts on Nick Saban's retirement? Fire Nick. Actually, I don't think I should say that because I don't actually know what that means. I was told to say that one time to make someone else mad, and I don't even know who Nick Saban is. But I tweeted it out once. Sorry. I'm sorry. Do you guys have any questions about streaming by chance? Because I can answer them as a mentor of the AT&T Class of Program 2024. The dinosaur question is not a streaming related question. It kind of is, but not really. Thanks, Mr. Clouds. Appreciate that. What LORP are you? I don't, what's the pink one called? Do you enjoy streaming? Yes. Plorp. Plorp is my glorp of choice. AT&T is watching this. Like, what is she talking about? Okay. Someone asked how I got into streaming. Yes, let me explain. All right. So in 2019, I was working at zoos. And I was doing traditional conservation education outreach, which is I was an education intern at a zoo. And so we brought animals out to schools and libraries and places like that and taught kids and adults about the animals that we had. So like the people that come in safari outfits to birthday parties and have the big snake and they're like, this is Martha. She's a Burmese python. You know, that's what I was doing in college. And I was also a falconer at the time. So I was rehabilitating a red-tailed hawk in 2019 named Bean. And one day I was streaming. I originally started streaming in the music section just for funsies. And then I, was talking about how I'm a falconer and people were like, you don't have a hawk. Let me see it. And so I brought the hawk out on stream. And the first time I did that, a clip of it, randomly, there was like some Redditor in my, what was it? It must've been like a 100-something person chat, posted on LSF and it went viral. On Reddit. And then I met a bunch of streamers through Reddit. A lot of streamers that I'm still friends with now. I moved to Texas because Austin, Texas is like a streamer hub for some reason, Soda Bobbin. And then I just kept streaming. I finished my degree in agricultural education and communications. But I finished it online because I've finished during COVID. I moved to Texas during COVID. I finished my degree here. And by the time I had finished my degree, I was like full time. Like my job was being a streamer. I founded Alveus Sanctuary in 2021. And I wanted to do, yeah, it's a BS in agriculture. I wanted to do the same thing that I was doing at zoos, conservation education outreach. I just wanted to do it online. Because when I brought Bean out and I did my red-tailed hawk spiel that I was doing at schools in classrooms, I was like, wait a second, I can do this online without having to take the animal anywhere. The animal just has to be okay with a camera and me, and I can teach way more people across the world instead of teaching like 20 kids in a classroom. And you know, you don't have kids like poking at him and screaming and, you know, doing whatever. And I was like, I can teach way more people this way in a way less intrusive way for these animals. So that's how the idea for Alvea started. And I made a 3-year plan in 2019. And I bought and started the nonprofit in 3 months. Pigeon, thank you for the 5 gifted subs. You win Chat Olympics. Sorry, Leonard. Congratulations. Thank you. So yeah, I made a 3-year plan and I started the nonprofit in 3 months. It's 3 year already. You know what? I've been streaming for 5 years. Actually, this month, 5 years. Stofi, thank you for the sub. I started streaming in April of 2019. And it's April of 2024, which is crazy that that's 5 years, because 2019 is only like 2 years ago. But yeah, it's been 5 years. Didn't you shave your head to start it or something? I did, yeah. I did a capital campaign fundraiser in 2021, February of 2021. And the goal for fundraising was $500,000. And I was like, there is no way that we raise $500,000. So I'm just going to put the goal, the top goal, as shaving my head. Because then it's like, because it's funny and it's meme-y and it's like crazy, you know, if we raise $500,000. And we raised $572,000. It was a 21-hour stream. We did a streamer auction. So streamers' items, like random lore items from streamers, like classic things from their stream, T-Pain shoes, like a bunch of random lore items. And we did an auction. I think that was the first time that someone really used the auction model for fundraising on Twitch. That was Space. Chat interactive live auction. Yeah, people were live, like it was a live auction. Like they were putting in their bids live. And because of that model, you could keep seeing the number going up. The streamers were reacting to the bids, and it was just an insane auction. And then we also did donor trees down at the studio, and so you could pay to get your name on a leaf, like engraved on a leaf on these trees. And so we have all these trees here at Alvaeus as well. And yeah, so we raised $250,000 or $250,000 just by people getting their names engraved on leaves. It was a crazy crowdfunding experience, unlike any I have ever had, obviously, and will ever have. So it's also a great example of chat interaction. But yeah, that is that's how I started on Twitch. And what kept me on Twitch is the education. Twitch is so powerful for educating people about the natural world. It's so unique and so important that I have access to this demographic, because this demographic is, like I said, like 18 to 35. Those are difficult people for normal conservation educators to reach. Traditional conservation education, you're either getting kids in classrooms, right? You're going to classrooms teaching kids, which is very important, or you're getting older people that are already interested in biology that are already in there, like birders, right? Twitch is an untapped reservoir for doing good is something that I always used to say. That's where the name of the sanctuary came from. Alvaeus is reservoir in Latin. It's super untapped, though, especially for education. What's really unique about this demographic is that it's, you guys are budding consumers. You guys are just now learning, or a lot of you are just now learning, like, what your staples are in your house and how to purchase ethically and what that means, you know? And so I'm able to teach you guys about that, about food labels, because otherwise you're probably not learning anywhere unless you already care, which is too small of a group of people. So we're just trying to teach you guys that there are problems so that you care about them. You're also budding voters, emerging voters. And so I'm able to teach you guys some about environmental policy and what's important there. So that's really special as well. I'm really passionate about the demographic that I have on Twitch and being able to teach them. It's really cool when I go to partner with other conservation organizations. I tell them what my demographic is and they're like so excited because they're like, oh my gosh, that's like the golden, that's like the golden zone. Like that's the zone we want to reach, but we can't. It's also you guys are so active in social media, you know, and there's so much power in education from social media. Obviously, as Alveus has shown. So that's really cool too. Yeah, all these people buying certified humane eggs. So cool. So cool. I'm more conscious of what I can consume. Thank you for teaching us. Hooray! Merch, the next merch launch will be in the summer for summer camp. Is there a way to test streaming if you only have a laptop and not sure if you'll like it? Yeah, I used to stream from a MacBook Air in college. I had a Yeti microphone, a Blue Yeti, and a MacBook Air. And I used the MacBook webcam for a while. And then I got a Logitech C920 to plug into that MacBook. It works. You can give it a go. You can give it a shot. You just have to download OBS. Put in your stream key, go live. You know? How do you... Okay, this is actually kind of a hard question. This person said... How do you get started streaming and push past the lack of viewership? Like, how do you not get deterred from quitting? Let me be very honest before I throw my two cents in here. I am exceptionally lucky when it comes to streaming. I got lucky. I went viral. I met a bunch of people very, very quickly. And I went from a, like, not even 100 viewer streamer to a 2,000 viewer streamer overnight. I never had to deal with that grind. I never felt defeated and had to keep pushing. I never had to do that. So be aware of that. I got very, very lucky via Reddit. So I have a super unfair advantage there. And most people don't get that opportunity. I will say, though, it's really hard, I imagine, when you start streaming, if you have really low viewership. The only thing that I'll recommend, and maybe this is not the advice that you want, just don't put all your eggs in one basket. Right? Streaming is really hard. Streaming can be really, really fun, but streaming is really, really fun on the side for most people. And if you can really grind and make it your job, great. But if you have another job, I really recommend that you keep your salary and then do streaming on the side as a passion project for fun until it at least reaches what you're making. Like, don't drop everything and try to just be a streamer because it's really hard. But there are so many people that are doing both. There are so many people that have a normal job and are streaming on the side and are streaming at night and on the weekends, and that's awesome. And eventually, hopefully, you get to the point where you can do it all the time if that's what you want to do. But just don't put all your eggs in one basket right away. Even me, I finished my degree even when I was averaging, what, like 4 or 5K? Because I was like, it's a social media platform. Who knows? Hi, Sean. Yeah, who knows what's gonna happen. So I wanted to finish that even though I was like a streamer at that time. Cross-posting content is good. Yeah, YouTube Shorts, TikTok, Instagram, Twitter, all that. But Twitch is where it's at, baby. I've been thinking of just doing it for fun. I'm working to become an art teacher. That's awesome. You can do art on Twitch. You can do anything on Twitch nowadays. Not anything, but a lot of things on Twitch. You can do art. You can do cooking. You can do hiking. You can do gaming. You can do chatting. Do you ever pause for a sec before you press live on a real note? On the day-to-day... No. Not anymore. I think I used to. But no. It's very routine now, I think. How did you go viral when you started? I don't know the lore. There was just a Redditor in my chat. I got lucky. I had a hawk out and I was talking about the hawk and he posted and everyone loved it. Just random. So random. It's crazy thinking about like what my life would be now if that guy was not in my chat. I don't know. Bean. Is that guy still here? Mm-mm. Not that I know of. I discovered you from YouTube videos where you interviewed animals with a tiny mic. Cool. Yeah, Tiny Mic. Tiny Mic's a fun series. What degree do you have? My degree is in agricultural education. How do you get comfortable talking in front of a camera? I feel like it really didn't take me long to feel fine about it. It feels very different than talking in person, but also I love public speaking. I realize it's like not, most people don't. I've liked public speaking since college. I've liked doing speeches and stuff since college. I think it took me some time when I first started streaming. I was like, oh my God, there's so many people here. But now it's just something that I'm super used to. Would you collab with any non-streamers? Yeah, this Friday I'm doing a collab with Ricky Glasser. He's a professional skateboarder. He's teaching me how to do a kickflip. You love public speaking but hate vlogging? Yeah. I don't like vlogging because I don't like feeling annoying. I went to Cal Poly. San Luis Obispo. How long did you stream to almost no viewers before blowing up? Dude. Legitimately? Like a week, probably. Maybe a couple weeks. I said, I'm not hiding it. I got very, very lucky very fast. When I'm saying, I started streaming in April 2019 and that clip went viral in May of 2019. Or April. Maybe it did go viral in April. You might be right. It might have been the same month. Your first stream is in February? Okay. Start streaming in February 2019. The clip went viral in April. So. Yeah. I got a question. Go ahead. Ouch. Someone also asked if it... Are you guys hiring? No smile. Somebody asked if it helps to have a unique personality to be a big streamer. Sure. I think one of the cool things about Twitch is that it offers so many pockets of the internet to so many people in one place. You know? Like, if you love cooking, you have a pocket. If you love animals, you have a pocket. If you love Valorant, you have a pocket. If you love art, you have a pocket. If you love music, you have a pocket. Like, there's so many places on Twitch where you can just go and be yourself and do what you love, and there will be people that are in that chat that are like, oh my God, I love this. Oh my God, I love doing this. Like, I love music. I love this. And that's really cool. So, yeah, Twitch is cool for that reason. Does game development have a pocket? Absolutely. Pirate software, baby. Get over there. What if you have pockets? I bet there are people sewing on Twitch. I bet there are. Go find them. You'll love them. Have you tried Valorant? No! Alright. Okay. Have you ever had a DDoSing incident? Yeah. Yeah, I have. I just went and bought a new router. It happens, you know what I mean? What originally made you want to pursue agriculture? I grew up on a farm. So I grew up around the livestock industry and with animals. Stream starts tomorrow at 9 a.m. Woo! On Nick's channel. 9 a.m. CT. It's 3 p.m. CT for reference if you're not here. Would you ever have Thor out for a collab? Absolutely. Absolutely. He is welcome here anytime. Would you ever consider playing nature-related game like Build-A-Zoo or Farm Sims? Yeah, I've done that a little bit. I tend to like streaming outside a lot more than at my desktop. You don't see me here that often. I like IRLing more, generally. Alveus is rescuing two wolves, hopefully in April. Yeah. The target goal was April 15th originally, but it might... It's probably going to be more like the end of April. We're doing our best. We're moving as fast as we can. Guys, I hope you liked the tips and tricks for today. I hope you guys like the chat Olympics. I had a lot of fun doing it. I had a lot of fun hosting it. It was cool to see you guys so into it. It was a really fun stream. I do want to do stuff like that more. I want to use it for summer camp for sure. It was a really good time. Huge shout out to AT&T for giving me the motivation to do this. Because honestly, if it wasn't for AT&T today, I probably wouldn't have put together chat Olympics with Space today. So it was very special that we got to do this today. And that's thanks to AT&T. AT&T is really helping creators be the best that they can be. They have a class of program 2024 where they've featured more than 75 up and coming creators, and they have mentors and mentees. Some of the mentors that they've had are Cypher PK, Extra Emily, Botez Sisters, myself, Lil Simsy, Aiden, Teepee, Shazam, It's Hafu, and now me as a mentor. And then they have mentees. The mentees are emerging creators. They're well-deserving streamers. They are grinding their way to get to the top. And AT&T and mentors like me are helping them develop their skills to grow their communities on Twitch. AT&T plans to help elevate the brands of these streamers through homepage. Obviously, I'm on front page today, thanks to AT&T. So they're helping us there. Incorporating them into custom commercials and providing raids from mentors. So I will be raiding one of the mentees today, which is fun. With the support of AT&T's power and their technology, along with Twitch's expertise and content creation, AT&T will set each class of member on a path to success to help making their streaming dreams a reality. It's a very, very cool program. They're really letting streamers be creative and do, you know, whatever makes their channel the best and whatever they want to do to have the best stream that they can. And that's really cool of them. Also, AT&T has fiber now delivering up to 5 gig speeds. You can check if it's available in your area. If you sign up now, you can get $150 in rewards cards and they will cover your cancellation fee in full. There's a link in chat to learn more. You can do command ATT fiber and you can earn up to $150 reward by signing up online. Thank you, AT&T, again, for sponsoring another stream. And thank you guys for participating in Chat Olympics. I had a really, really great time today. I think it was fun. We have a lot of work to do tonight. Setting up for the rock party tomorrow. My stream tomorrow is on NMPLOL's channel at 9 a.m. in the morning. So I will see you guys bright and early with NMP, LOL, and we will be fundraising for the Wolf Enclosure. If you come to Nick's stream tomorrow, if you could link his channel, that would be great. If you donate $50, we're going to have streamers paint your username on a rock. It's a fundraiser. And the rocks will be sealed up, and we'll put them all over the brand new wolf enclosure. We're rescuing 2 wolves this month at Alveus. And so all of your usernames and all of your rocks will go in the wolf enclosure, which will be very cool. So if you want a rock that we'll paint and it'll go in the enclosure, come to Nick's stream tomorrow. It should be really, really cool. It's very important. You know, these wolves deserve absolutely the best life possible. We are trying to build them the best enclosure that we possibly can, and it is very expensive. I would really, really appreciate your guys's support. It would be awesome. So I will see you guys there tomorrow. Nick and I are reuniting, and I'm going to raid Mentee. Stand by. I am raiding Patty. Wait, I'm excited. Patty's funny. Okay, I'm gonna raid Patty, who's one of the mentees in the AT&T Class of program. Again, thank you so much, AT&T, for sponsoring this stream. Thank you guys for playing in the chat Olympics today. All of you lose except for Leonard, remember that. And I will see you tomorrow on Nick's stream, hooray! Go say hi to Patty, everybody. Go say hi to Patty, funny guy. I hope that's the right username. It is, right? Can we make sure that's correct? I think it's correct. Otherwise, we're gonna have some random Patty's gonna be very confused. All right, sick. Excellent. Yes, you must all buy a rock. You, in particular, you are required to purchase a rock. You in particular, and I will be holding you to it tomorrow. Thank you very much. See you guys tomorrow. Goodbye. Thank you.